Good morning, my dear students. I am going to start a convection heat transfer. This is a repetition class. Yesterday, I concluded the session related to transient heat conduction and also the revision portion of basic conduction equation. Now, I will come to the convection heat transfer. The convection heat transfer is the energy exchange. Takes place between the higher temperature region to a lower temperature region due to the molecular motion and macroscopic motion of the fluid particles. See, the convection heat transfer is further classified into two. One is a natural convection or free convection, and another one is a forced convection. If the mixing motion takes place due to the density difference caused by the temperature gradient, then the process of heat transfer is known as the natural convection or free convection. You know that the density difference should be there for cause of natural convection heat transfer. Then if the forced convection is the one which is going to be occur by means of external means. It means you have to apply some disturbance in the motion of fluid, then it will cause a forced convection. The forced convection is the mixing motion takes place due to the external means such as pump, blower, then the process is known as heat transfer by forced convection. The effective transport of energy by this mode is merely dependent on nature of mixing of fluid. Therefore, the knowledge of characteristic of fluid flow is necessary to study the heat transfer phenomena by convection. You know that convection heat transfer is x is equal to q divided by directly the heat transfer RS q is equal to HEA delta T. Therefore, H is equal to Q divided by A delta T. So, this is the convection heat transfer coefficient. What is the unit for convection heat transfer coefficient? The H convection heat transfer coefficient unit is watt per meter square Kelvin, per meter square area you are going to calculate. Therefore, the knowledge of characteristic of fluid flow is very much necessary for the study of transport phenomena by convection. Otherwise, it is very difficult to understand the natural convection or forced convection phenomena. If you don't have a knowledge of fluid flow, because already you studied fluid mechanics the fluid flow equations, and that is made use here to calculate the heat transfer rate by natural convection or by forced convection. Okay, let us consider a hot plate of surface temperature TW and fluid temperature T infinity flowing parallel to the plate. As a result of viscous force, the velocity of fluid will be zero near the base of the plate and increases to the free stream velocity as you move up from the figure. The velocity of fluid layer is zero at the ball, and the heat transfer only by conduction to the wall to the fluid, and the rate of heat transfer from wall to the fluid is calculated by using the equation, and also the figure is given. So this is the wall, so this is the plate. Perpendicular, the depth of the plate is perpendicular to the board, and you know that the plate is getting heated up. The wall temperature is TW. This is the wall temperature, and the free stream velocity is U infinity. Okay, and the velocity profile is given there, given here. The fluid flow is also given here. So the
one minute. And I wanted to get the data and book and see the convection heat transfer coefficient is also given in page number 44. The equation is given like that. So Q is equal to delta overall by R. R is the thermal resistance that is given in the page number 44 of data and book that you can take. And this is the mechanism which I shown. This is the velocity profile and this is the temperature profile. There are two profiles which I am showing. This is velocity profile. It means as the velocity, free stream velocity comes over and then touches the plate, and then this is how the velocity gradient going to be get increased as it moves to the free stream velocity. U infinity is the free stream velocity, and at the wall it is zero, and at the free stream it is U infinity. U is zero, velocity is zero here, and then it is keep on increasing. It means as you go up, this is a zero and this is the highest velocity you can get. Similarly, the temperature at the wall is more. As you move up, the temperature of the fluid keep decreasing, and as the temperature profile is keep on going up, and then this is the representation of temperature profile for the free stream velocity. Okay, the velocity and temperature profile for convection heat transfer from the heated surface, it is as shown in figure 1.2. Okay. This is a simple representation of heat transfer. See, the concept of heat transfer by convection was introduced by Newton's in 1701, and he recommend the following equation to take into account the heat flow from the solid surface to the fluid. Okay. So he recommended the following equation to take into account the heat flow from the solid surface to a fluid. Q is equal to H into A, that is A is the square meter area into heat transfer coefficient into wall temperature minus the free stream temperature, where TW is the wall temperature in degree Celsius and T infinity is the temperature of fluid in degree Celsius. It has proved to be really a definition H rather than the law. Under a steady heat flow condition, you can also have the heat conducted at x is equal to L, heat conducted from the boundary to the adjacent fluid. So that equation can be rewritten like this. It means first it will conduct from the wall and then it is get convected. So simply I will write the wall or the plate. This is the plate. The heat is first get conducted, Q, and then it is convected out like this. Q convection and this is conduction. This is convection. Okay. There are two phenomena occurring. One is heat is conducted by the wall to the air. Near the vicinity of this wall, the air is accumulating heat and then it moves up at the x is equal to 0 at this point, x is equal to L at this point. Or whatever you take, then over the length of the slab you can take, and this is the limit that I am going to take, x is equal to 0 and x is equal to L. So as you move, the plate is keep on increasing its temperature because the velocity profile is also increasing. Temperature is having high profile here. Okay, it is seen from the equation that for a system in which the wall temperature and free stream temperature and thermal conductivity K and H constant and dT by dx is L. In other words, heat transfer coefficient can be considered fundamentally as a measure of slope of the temperature distribution in the fluid at the right surface. So, the next come to the radiation heat transfer. You know, radiation is you know that already in the previous definition is Q is equal to minus K
dt by dx is equal to hea, and this is tw minus t infinity, right? And then you can take it out h, you'll get the whatever the equation you get,
that is called the heat transfer by convection. Okay, radiation is a process in which the flow of heat takes place from high temperature body to the low temperature. It is obvious that this is the phenomena by nature. And when the body are separated in space, not necessarily they are very near, when they are separated by space in the space also, they are going to exchange heat even when the vacuum exists between them. It means there is no, not necessarily the continuum should be there, even the vacuum exists also, you can also exchange the heat. Okay, it can also transfer or emit the heat from one surface to the other surface. It means one from one body to the other body. So this is very difficult to provide a simple physical picture for this radiation sometimes, which is quite visible and travels with a finite ease through empty space. It means it is very easy and it will pass through. Radiation can be penetrate even, you know, that radiation, we are talking about thermal radiation between the bandwidth of the frequency bandwidth. I am talking about 0.4 to 4 micrometer. That is called visible radiation. 4 micrometer is a visible radiation, and infrared radiation is start from 0.4 micrometer to 4 micrometers. So within this range only we are talking about the radiation. The term radiation is generally applied to all kind of electromagnetic wave phenomena. How the energy will transmit? This is by electromagnetic wave phenomena, but in heat transfer only those phenomena which are a result of temperature. The energy transmitted in this manner is termed as radiation heat transfer. All body continuously emits energy in the form of wave because of their temperature, and the energy emitted is called thermal radiation. It means any object in the nature, if you consider, they got some temperature. Even zero is also a temperature, even minus 70 is also a temperature, and it should possess some value. It means body continuously emit energy in this form of electromagnetic waves because of their temperature, and energy thus emitted is called thermal radiation. So the radiation energy emitted by the body is transmitted in the space in the form of electromagnetic wave as per the Maxwell electromagnetic wave theory, or in the form of discrete photons, or as per the Planck's hypothesis. There are two hypotheses. Theories that you have to understand. One is electromagnetic wave radiation, that is Maxwell radiation. Another one is discrete photons by Planck's hypothesis. These are the two laws which governs the energy emitted by radiation. But the thermodynamic consideration shows that the ideal thermal radiator or the black body which emits energy at a rate proportional to the 4th power of the absolute temperature of the body and directly proportional to the surface area. So this is what this is what the equation that I have derived, that is this is known as Stefan-Boltzmann law of radiation, and is applied to only black bodies. The maximum energy that is emitted by the black body at a temperature T is given by Eb is equal to sigma T to the power of 4 sigma T to the power of 4 watt per meter square. So where T is the absolute temperature in Kelvin, and Eb is the body, black body emission or emissivity power, you call it as, or the energy emitted by the black body, and sigma is the Stefan-Boltzmann constant, that is equal to 5.6697 into 10 raised to minus 8 watt per meter square Kelvin to the power of 4. The radiation emitted by the real body is always less than that of the black body, and is given by Q is equal to, that is the radiation energy, Q is equal to epsilon and Eb. Epsilon is the emissivity
the amount of energy or the heat transferred by the black body is with the emissivity factor and the energy emitted by the body. Energy emitted by the body is EB. That if you substitute here, what you get? Epsilon sigma t to the power of 4. This is a unitless value. That is sigma. Emissivity is only a number. It ranges from 0 to 1. The limit is 0 to 1. If it is 1 is there, it is a perfectly black body. Perfectly black body and it emits 100% radiation. If it is a body is looks white to your eye, it is a black body. Okay, it absorbs all the radiation, the emission and radiation. Suppose if you consider ice, barf, what you can see, the snow, all are looking like a white body to your eye, but it is there perfectly black body. But how the ice melts, it absorbs all the radiation and then start melting. It means energy transmitted from one body, it is getting absorbed and then keep on melting. It is once start melting, finally it becomes water. Okay, how it the ice getting melt? If you keep ice cube on the table, and how it melts? It is by the emission of the energy from other body, it is get absorbed into that. That is, absorptivity is 100%. The emissivity of the other body is getting absorbed by the ice cube or the snow, it's going to be get melted. Okay, this is how the energy transmits in the media. It means it is in the continuum. 1 minute. So the amount of radiation that we are going to count in terms of the Stefan-Boltzmann constant and the emissivity factor and the temperature of the body is to be considered. There are three factors you consider. Okay, that is how the energy transport from the body is going to be considered. Okay, where emissivity is which lies between the zero and unity, for all real bodies it is always less than one. So it is emissivity of the body lies between zero and unity. For all real bodies it is less than one, because black body is only equal to one. All real bodies means which are seeing in the nature, table, fan, whatever is there, computer or whatever the object which are there in the world, their emissivity is always less than one. Heat exchange between the two bodies takes place by radiation only when there exists a temperature difference. It means radiation won't occur if there is no temperature difference exists between the two bodies. Suppose if you are standing before the furnace, you experience the amount of heat you are received to your body. It means you will also feel some energy is coming out from that. How do you experience unless this, there are two theories. One is Maxwell theory and Planck's theory. Maxwell theory is electromagnetic wave radiation, another one is the photons theory by radiation. Photons means all this energy comes in a discrete step and then hit the body and then get dissipated. This is by the radiation effect. Okay, the heat exchange between the two bodies takes place by radiation only when there exists a temperature difference, a result of heat exchange, hot body getting cooled and cooled body getting heat. That's what, if there are two bodies exist at temperature T1 and T2, then the net radiation heat loss will be, there are two equations are there, Q is equal to sigma T1 minus T2 to the power of 4 for a black body. And for real bodies, you have to add these two terms. It means these two terms are necessary to add to a real body. Okay, then only it is going to be like this. Okay, there are two equations, which are for black body and also for real bodies. For a black body, you have to multiply with the emissivity. Only real bodies you have to, because it is less than one, and you have to that factor to be taken there. Okay. Now coming to the simple examples that we are going to solve on conduction and also by radiation and also by convection also, I am going to solve that. Okay. First example that I am, determine the heat transfer H across, it means the, actually it is a 4 meter square area. A material of thickness 6 cm when the temperature difference of 100 degrees is applied across it, the thermal conductivity of material is 0.08 watt per meter degree Celsius. It means the conductivity of material is given. Simple equation you have to give. So this heat transfer H is there. It is heat transfer actually Q. It is not H. Okay. That is wrongly printed here. Thermal conductivity of material is 0.08. So now by using a simple equation, Q is equal to minus Ka dT by dx. Simply apply this equation. Q is equal to minus k a dt by dx. Solving one problem. Q is equal to minus k a dt by dx. You know all the values are given the
right side of the homogeneous equation. This is the Fourier's law of thermal conduction, where k is the conductivity, and here given more 4 meter square area. Okay, so that way you have to substitute the values, and then you can calculate the heat lost in terms of kilojoule. 1000 is divided for this equation is because of to convert the joule into kilojoule. Okay, so that is how the equation is taken into, and 100 is the temperature difference, and conductivity k is 0.08 divided by 1000 to convert, and the distance is 6 centimeter. 6 centimeter divided by 100 is convert into meter, and you will get kilojoule per hour energy lost from the heat transfer from the material of thickness 6 centimeter. Okay, go to the next problem. Determine the thermal conductivity of material, say asbestos. Asbestos sheet you have seen of 4 centimeter thick. When the temperature difference of 35 degree exists between the inner and outer surface of the material, the asbestos, the heat flow rate is 100 watt per meter square. So the solution, given that A is equal to 1 meter square, it means you have to take area 1 meter square, and dx is equal to 4 centimeter, and dt is equal to 35 degree, and q is 100 watts. You have to find out the conductivity of the material. So among the one equation, among any one parameter is going to ask. So the temperature difference is given, that is dx by dt, dt by dx is given, dx value is given, and dt value is given. Dx value is 4 centimeter. It means if it is a asbestos sheet is there, and this is the dx value, and the temperature difference here dt is given. You can, by taking this dt, dx value. Dx value is 4 by 100. It means 4 centimeters thick is there. Dx is, this is 4 centimeter. This value is 4 centimeter. And dt value is 35 degree Celsius. You know, these two values are given. Directly you can substitute on the equation and find out the value of k. K should be in watts per meter degree Celsius. All these equations are given in the data handbook. Page number, probably page number, 44 you can go. Okay, 44 and 45, the equations are given. Directly you can take that equation and then start solving the problem. Okay, now go to the third problem. The hard surface of material 55 centimeter thick, and then thermal conductivity is 20 watts per meter degree Celsius. Exist at a temperature of 200 degree Celsius. If the heat flow across the surface is 300 watt per meter square, find the temperature of the cold surface. The, given that the K is equal to 300 watt per meter degree Celsius, and area is 1 meter square, and dx is 55 centimeter, Q is equal to 300 watt per meter square. So you know the, you should find the temperature difference is asking. So same equations are that I'm going to use. Instead of dt, T1 minus T2 I can take. Where do you take T1 minus T2? If the model is taken like this, this is the thickness of the body, and this is T1, and this one is T2. Between two surfaces, it means T1 and T2. This is at this surface is at temperature T1, and this surface is at temperature T2. And the depth of the body is like this. Already it is given. This is T1 and this is T2. So this is the cross section of the body. Okay, that's how we are taken. Say the hot surface of material of 55 millimeter thick. It means this is instead of 4, this is 55 millimeter. Sorry, centimeter. It's supposed to be in centimeter. And that value you have to convert this into meter. That is 0.55 meter you get divided by 100 I have taken. And temperature difference you apply that, you will get a 191.75 degree Celsius you are going to get. Substituting same equation, same equation I am using, and then I am calculating the temperature difference between two surfaces. Okay. So the again another problem is given to calculate the amount of heat flow. Determine the heat flow across the plane wall of 10 centimeter thickness and thermal conductivity 9 watt per meter degree Celsius. When the surface temperature are steady at 100 degree and 25 degree Celsius, the wall area is 4 meter square. Find also the temperature gradient in the flow direction. So this is what the given. So you can also calculate the, and looks, problem looks very simple. I have solved many problems. You can also practice, and by substituting all the values in this, you will get the 2700 watts energy. So dt by dx also you can calculate 750 degrees Celsius per meter, and directly you can use, or you can use this equation, or directly you can use and then substitute in this equation directly. So that is ka dt by dx. Q is equal to ka dt by dx, and R you can use this, and this is the wall temperature I have taken. This is 100 degree and this is 25 degree. Q is flowing right from this point and then going out of this, and length is equal to 10 centimeter is given. All the values substituted here, dx by 100 by 10 by 100 is converted into meter, and 100 minus 25 is the temperature gradient. That value you will get 75 degree. I directly can use this equation dt by dx and then calculate R. dt by dx is equal to minus q by ka, also you can use because the thermal conductivity is given. Per minute, the area is also given. You can substitute and then calculate that. Okay. So, another problem on convection I am going to take. Very simple equation. The determine the heat transfer per meter square of the plate when the water is at a mean temperature of 30 degree. The flows over it at 80 degree Celsius, the heat transfer coefficient is 250 watts per meter square degree Celsius. So you know that given area is equal to 1 meter square, and you assume that area 1 meter square only you have to take. T infinity is equal to 30 degree and TW is equal to 80 degree, and H is equal to 100 watt per meter square degree Celsius, and Q you have to calculate. So Q is equal to HEA TW minus T infinity. Using this equation, using this equation, we can calculate the heat flow is equal to 250 multiplied by the area is equal to 1, and the temperature difference is 180 minus 30. So using this, you can also calculate that is 12500 watt. So the unit for consistency is, if this is in watt per meter degree Celsius, area is in meter square, and temperature difference is in degree Celsius also. So the convection heat transfer coefficient is watt per meter square degree Celsius. Meter square get cancelled, and degree Celsius get cancelled, you only get watts. So therefore, you can also check this value. So the heavy water, another problem, problem number 6, heavy water flows inside a 6 cm diameter and 2 cm long pipe with its surface temperature maintained 150 degrees Celsius. Determine the heat transfer rate from the tube to the water if the heat transfer coefficient between the water and the tube is 2500 watt per meter square degree Celsius, and water temperature is at 40 degree. You know, diameter is 6 cm is given, length is 2 meters given, temperature is 40 and 150 degree is given, the different temperatures. Heat transfer coefficient is also given, and Q you ask you to calculate. It means area you have to multiply. HA is pi d L. It means surface area you have to take. Tube is there, no? You cannot take the cross sectional area. How? I am going to give that geometry to make you understand how the heat flows through the tube. How you have to take. If this is the tube, it is having thickness and length is equal to 2 meter. How the heat transfer takes place? It takes place from the surface. It means it comes out from the surface in all directions. It means surface area pi d into L, length you have to take. This is the length. This is how the area is taken. This is L, and pi d is the circumference. Surface area is pi d into L, that I have taken, and TW minus T infinity, wall temperature is 40 and ambient temperature is wall temperature 150 and ambient temperature is 40 degree. Substitute in the above equation, that is Q is equal to H pi d L into T W minus T infinity.
Substitute in this equation, you will get in terms of watts. Okay, that is 2500 multiplied by 6 divided by 100 into 2. This you will get the answer. A surface with a, another problem, a surface with a, this is a radiation problem I am going to solve. The surface with an area of 2 meter square has the temperature of 200 degrees Celsius. It exchanges heat with another surface at 30 degrees Celsius by radiation. Determine the heat exchange, assuming that the surface are black bodies. Surfaces are black body. Also find the value of thermal resistance and equivalent convective coefficients. Okay, sigma value is given, that you have to assume, you have to remember this because it is given in the data handbook. You can directly take from the data handbook. Page number 44 is given, or in, go to the radiation topic in the data handbook. You take the sigma value, that is Stefan Boltzmann constant, that is 5.6697 into 10 raised to minus 8, I think. I am not visible, it is 8 only. Okay, temperature T1 200 degree, T2 is 30 degree, and area is 2 meter. You can calculate Q and H radiation also. So, from the, using this equation, you can calculate Q. Q is equal to delta T by R, where R is the resistance. How do you calculate R? Delta T by R is the resistance that you have to take, degree Celsius per watt, and putting that resistance here, you will get that watt per meter square Kelvin, R value in terms of HR. HR you have to calculate, no? From this equation, you can calculate HR is equal to 1 divided by RR into area of, you consider, okay, 1 by 0.36 multiplied by 2 area. You will get this 13.88 watt per meter square Kelvin. There is convective heat transfer by radiation. Convective heat transfer by radiation that you are going to get. So there is a little big problem for this, and the hot plate made of stainless steel of size 600 mm and 750 mm. This is the area is given, 600 millimeter into 750 millimeter, and thickness of 20 millimeter is maintained at 250 degrees Celsius. Atmospheric air is at 27 degree, blows over this plate, calculate the heat transfer, and inside plate temperature is 300 watt. It lost from the surface of a plate by radiation. Assuming the convective heat transfer coefficient of 30 watt per meter square Kelvin, and thermal conductivity of the plate is 4500 watt per meter degree Celsius. The radiation. So the assuming convective heat transfer coefficient is 30 watt per meter square Kelvin, thermal conductivity of the plate is 4500. Double time it is printed. Okay. Now the data given, you have to solution, and data given you have to take. The area is 600 millimeter by 750 millimeter. Thickness is 20, that is X value. And temperature is 27 degree, and wall temperature is 250 degrees Celsius. Atmospheric temperature is 20. And Q value is given, amount of heat transferred to the, from the wall to the surface or to the air, it is 300 watts. Heat transfer, convective heat transfer coefficient is given, conductivity of the material is given, temperature T1, T2 you have to calculate. By convection. Okay. So now we have to add two equations. One is by convective heat transfer coefficient, you can directly calculate the amount of heat emitted. Therefore, total heat conducted by a plate surface is first by convection and plus by radiation. So conduction equation is minus Ka dT by dx. Now both the values are given. By radiation 300 watts is given. By convection already calculated in the above equation. This is the convection heat transfer equation. This is the radiation already given in the data. Adding this, you can find out the dT value. How much is the difference in temperature? 253.27 degree. If it is maintained, it is possible to exchange so much of heat. That is 10.5 watts plus 300 watts. That is the amount of heat possible to transfer by radiation as well as by convection from the conducted plate. Okay, this is what the simple problem is given. So another problem I have to go. A long copper pipe of 100 mm diameter with its surface temperature 70 degree is passing through a pipe which is maintained at a temperature of 25 degree. It means that there is a pipe passing through a room which is having a 25 degree. Calculate the heat loss by the pipe per meter length of, assuming the heat transfer coefficient of air is 7 watt per meter square degree Celsius and emissivity of the pipe is 0.75.
this real body that you are going to consider, and all the data given is written here: 25 degree, wall temperature 70 degree, convective transfer 7 watt per meter square Kelvin, length is equal to 1 meter, and diameter is 100 meters. So the emissivity is given 0.75, and Stefan-Boltzmann constant is taken like this, and 5.66 into 10^-8. So you have to calculate by convection, by radiation, and the total value of that. This is the geometry, copper pipe.
Same pipe I am talking about,
whatever the pipe is there. The total heat lost by the pipe surface by combined mechanism, because in your syllabus it is mentioned that what is the heat transfer by combined mechanism. Combined mechanism by conduction, radiation, and convection, both are there. That combined mechanism equation that I am going to take, heat transferred by convection, HA delta T, that is H into pi DL, A is pi DL. It means surface area that I am going to take. You can ask me a question, why you should not take the cross-sectional area. Cross-sectional area you cannot take because the fluid is flowing inside the tube and it won't transmit through the wall, but it is not flowing, the heat is not flowing through the axial direction. It flows in the radial direction. Heat flow is in the radial direction, but water is flowing, or whatever the fluid is flowing, in the axial direction. Heat flow is in the radial direction. It means as per the Fourier's law of thermal conduction, you can say that the amount of heat transferred perpendicular to the area exposed, normal to the direction of heat flow. That's what the normal to the area exposed. It means this surface area. So area exposed normal is surface area of the tube you have to take. So from that, what you get? You will get 98.91 watt per meter. Only thing the student have to remember here, that the unit conversion and the whatever the unit that you are giving, that is dimension that you are giving, that should be properly converted into meters, and then later you have to substitute in the given equation. Equations are also given in the data handbook. Directly you can take this equation and then substitute in the appropriately and then calculate. See, this will come only by practice. Unless you practice, you won't get. So this is the total. It means convection by radiation you have to calculate. So another equation is by radiation I calculate sigma emissivity is given, that is why emissivity into Stefan-Boltzmann constant into area T1 to the power of 4, T2 to the power of minus 4, substituting all the values. So we can get the equation. So the total energy transmitted is from the tube when it passing through the room is, per meter length of the tube you have to take, it is 178.325 watt per meter. It means meter length you have taken. 2 meter already you have divided, that is why you can take. So another problem, and same problem is given. See the problem number 10, a salt sufficient problem we can also go through, because it is also on radiation and also by convection. We have convection, radiation, and total you had calculated, and the, it's similar to the previous problem. You can go like this. Okay, the geometry is given. This is how this is going to be calculated. You can also go through. So here I equated heat conducted is equal to heat conducted plus heat radiated. So all that you have to add and then find the temperature. Finally, the T1, what is the table temperature? You can also go through this because it is given. You can copy it down, or you can note it down. You can also calculate this. Okay. This problem can be asked for 8 marks or maximum 10 marks. Thank you. The first our class is, it means the first lecture which I repeated. Then I go to the second lecture. What I have taken in the second lecture? Second lecture I started condition of the boundary condition, different boundary conditions that I want to talk about. The first and second boundary conditions I am talking about. The appropriate boundary conditions are required to specify any problem. See, the boundary condition I'll give the best example is each country will have its boundary and managed by the zone policies of the country. See, you got how many boundaries in our India? How many boundaries are there? So you got, it's a tropical country. You got Sri Lanka, there is a boundary. It means they have divided. From Gulf, what is your Gulf countries are there, and what is the distance you have to occupy in the ocean? That also specified. That is Arabian Sea and ocean of Hind, and also West Bengal. There is a Bengal Ocean, West Bengal. It means that is the ocean. There are three oceans are covered, and the three direction water is there, and one direction land is there. So they bounded by Pakistan, Nepal, China, and also Burma, and other countries also there. Okay, these countries, and they have got their boundaries, shared their boundaries. It means they have got their own specific conditions. Similarly, in heat transfer also, we have got a boundary condition. These also used for, these boundary conditions also used specifically to analyze the problem. And design engineers also use the different boundary condition to analyze the problem. Okay, similarly, the electronics engineer also use this, specify the boundary conditions in order to analyze the signals. Okay, and there also they got differential equation to solve it. It means engineering is full of differential equation, and whatever the condition that you apply, you have to simplify the equation, get the answer. For that, there are three boundary condition. One is temperature boundary condition, convection boundary condition, and heat flux boundary condition. Any body which has got a temperature, it means you should specify the temperature boundary condition. And anything is there which is kept in air, okay? And we are all surrounded by air only, not water. We are not aquariums. And we are not moving always in water. We are moving always in air only. It means the thermal, convective boundary condition means how much heat is transferred from our body to the air to the body, that is by convection. Okay? The radiation boundary conditions also can give, that is the convective radiation you are going to take. Convective heat transfer by radiation, HR, you are going to take. Okay? Boundary conditions specify the surface region. That is a prescribed temperature boundary condition, prescribed heat flux boundary condition, and convective boundary condition. There are three boundary conditions. So what is the temperature at time t? It means there are two coordinates. One is space coordinate and time coordinate you have to use. There are two coordinates that you are going to use. It means we are not using, this is a steady state boundary condition that you are going to use. Then time is zero. Initial condition to specify the temperature at the origin when the time is zero. Time coordinate is always zero. That you have to remember, okay? So these physical boundary conditions should be represented with appropriate mathematical expressions. These commonly used boundary conditions that you are going to use, that is the first one that you are going to take, prescribed temperature boundary condition, that is boundary condition of first kind, okay? There are numerous applications in which the temperature of the boundary surface is considered known. You know, no, anybody, any object, if we keep it, surface temperature is known to you. If you measure, it will give. Now, the best example is the coronavirus affected man. How do you first you check his body whether it is affected by coronavirus or not? You see, that body is running high temperature than the normal, at most 3 degrees high temperature than the normal. You know that our body will not withstand more than, if it is 97 Fahrenheit, or it should be 37 degrees Celsius. This is in degrees Celsius, this is in Fahrenheit. If it is goes another 3 degree, it become 100. 100 degree, it goes 39 or 38.5 or 39. If this is the temperature, and you feel that if it is 1 degree above, it is a fever, 1 degree below, it's a cold. Okay, and body is so tuned by our metabolic activity, and whatever the condition is there, the body is going to be so controlled, because you have got a very high immunity. Immunity means the youngsters have got more immunity to resist the virus effect, and those who are 70 plus and they are having some diseases, then they cannot able to survive because of the temperature, okay, and is affected. I am coming to the why I am giving this example is that the temperature they are going to see by non-contact means, by thermal radiation. It means the radiation cameras are there, just you project one light, it will reflect back and then it gives the temperature of the body. But this is the one non-contact measuring devices they are going to use in the airports. If it is more than 100 degree, immediately that person is get segregated and then isolated from all the contacts and is kept for observation more than 22 degree. It means, what is that you are measuring? There is a temperature boundary you are measuring to him, not anything else. It means it will clear indication that he is suffering. So same thing, temperature, prescribed temperature boundary condition that you are going to use. Okay. 1 minute. So there are numerous applications in which the temperature boundary surface is considered known. For example, the boundary surface is in contact with the melting ice is said to be maintained at uniform temperature. It means the ice temperature is always at zero when it kept on the surface of the table. Distribution of the boundary surface is known as a function of time. So the you can consider plate of thickness and temperature. See, suppose you consider a thick plate and this is the flow of heat with a different temperature. This is T1 surface temperature, this is T2 at this point, at these two points. X is equal to 0 and this is X is equal to L. Therefore, length is how much? Length is L. I think you could be able to see that. Okay, length L. So the conductivity of the material is K. So it is very simple that Q is flowing in this direction. Heat is flowing in this direction and then it is decreases when it passing through the wall and then temperature will become T2. So how do you specify the boundary condition at initially at X is equal to 0? There are two values. T is equal to X comma T. That at T is equal to 0. It means at X is equal to 0, X comma T. It means X is equal to 0. At this point, X is equal to 0. Therefore, T0 comma T you get, that is equal to T1. Similarly, X is equal to Tx comma T, temperature T, in bracket, X is the location comma time T, at X is equal to L at this point. So therefore, the boundary condition that you are going to specify, TL comma T is equal to T2, the temperature T2. These are the two boundary conditions they have to go. More general case, the distribution of temperature boundary surface may be specified as a function of position and time. Okay. And time is equal to 0 you are considering basically because it is a steady state heat flow. When the temperature prescribed at boundary surface and boundary condition is said to be first kind, this is similar to the boundary condition for cylinder and sphere also. This is the boundary temperature boundary condition of first kind. Boundary condition of first kind, that is how we are going to specify. So I can write Tx comma T at X is equal to 0, therefore this T0 comma T and this can be written as T1. Similarly, Tx comma T at X is equal to L, therefore it is T L comma T is equal to T2. It means T1 and T2 directly can take. So this is what the temperature. So that's how it is given representation. Tx comma Tx is equal to 0 is T1. Tx comma T, X is equal to L is equal to T2. This is a prescribed temperature of boundary condition of first kind that you are going to take. So this prescribed heat flux boundary condition of second kind. In some situation, the rate of heat supply to the boundary surface is considered known. For example, on the electrically heated surface, the rate of heat flow entering the solid is known. Such boundary conditions are called prescribed heat boundary conditions, heat flux boundary conditions. It means Q value if it is specified, then it is known as the heat flux boundary condition. So similarly, you are going to consider the same boundary condition is Q naught, the heat flux that you are going to consider. So this is how we are going to consider. This is Q naught is equal to K dT by dx, where Q naught is equal to capital Q by A. Q naught is equal to capital Q by A. It means rate of heat flow divided by area is called the heat flux. Heat flux is expressed in watts per meter square. Okay, this equation is used, and this I think time is up now. Yes, 12:50. Now I'm going to take up this in the next class, and repetition I'm going to take it in the next class. Thank you very much.